will discuss answer of lesson number 5, separation of substances. First question is, why do we need to separate different components of a mixture? Give two examples. So why do we need to separate different components of a mixture? So we have to give the two examples. And answer is, why we need to separate different components of a mixture? To separate the useful components from the non-useful or some harmful components. So why do we need to separate different components of a mixture? Give two examples. So first answer is, we need to separate different component of a mixture to separate the useful components from the non-useful or some harmful components. So you have, if we want to separate the useful component from the harmful component, so that's why we need to separate the different components of a mixture. And what are the examples? Suppose if you want to separate tea leaves from the tea, so we use the methods of separation. Next is, if pebbles are separated from the rice and pearls, then this is the reason. This is the example for which we want to need the separation of components. So why do we need to separate different components of a mixture? We need to separate different components of a mixture if you want to separate the useful components from the non-useful components or from the some harmful components. So this is the reason we need to separate different components of a mixture. And what are the examples? First is, tea leaves are separated from the tea. If you want to separate the tea leaves from the tea, and if you want to separate the pebbles from the rice and pearls, so this is the reason we need to separate different components of a mixture. So next is, what is winnowing and where is it used? What do you mean by winnowing? The process of separating heavier and lighter component of a mixture with the help of wind or the blow, the by the blowing air is called winnowing. So what do you mean by winnowing? If you want to separate heavier and lighter components of a mixture by wind or with the help of blowing air is called winnowing. So what do you mean by winnowing? So if you want to separate the process of separating heavier and lighter components of a mixture with the help of wind, then its process is called winnowing. So if we want to separate the higher and lighter components of a mixture with the help of wind, then this is called winnowing. And where it is used? If you want to separate heavier and lighter components. Next is, how will you separate husk or dirt particles from a given sample of pulses before cooking? So how can we separate dirt particles from a given sample of pulses before cooking? So answer is, husk or dirt particle can be separated by winnowing method. So if you want to separate the husk or dirt particle with the help of wind, then how will you separate husk or dirt particles? Husk or dirt particles can be separated with the help of winnowing, and means it with the help of wind, we can separate husk or dirt particles. So it is used to separate the heavier and lighter components of a mixture with the help of wind or with the help of blowing air. So if you want to separate the husk or dirt particles, so we need the winnowing method. Means with the help of wind, we can separate the husk or dirt particles from a given pulses. So it is where it is used to separate the heavier and lighter components with the help of wind. And how can we done it with this process? In this method, we take husk and grains together and we will sit at a height and then we will put this mixture on our shoulders. And then the mix, then this mixture falls down and the lighter particles is taken away with the help of wind and heavier grains is separated from the lighter one. So in this way, we can separate husk or dirt particles from a given sample of pulses. Firstly, jo hum husk or dirt particles ko hum winnowing method se separate karte hain. And with the help of wind, हवा से जो हम उसको separate करते हैं, इस method की method कैसे करते हैं हम? Husk और seeds और grain को हम combine कर देते हैं, और हम किसी भी height पे खड़े हो जाते हैं. Height पे खड़े होने के बाद, हम अपने shoulder पे उसको रख लेते हैं उस mixture को, और उसको नीचे डालते हैं. नीचे डालने के बाद जो lighter husk होता है, वो हवा से उड़ जाता है, और बाद में क्या बच जाता है? Heavier grains are left. Heavier grains are left. So in this way, we can separate the heavier grains from the seeds. So this is the method of winnowing. So with the help of wind, we can separate husk or dirt particles from a given sample of pulses. Next is, what is sieving and where can it use? What do you mean by sieving? So if you want to separate the process of separating fine particles from the larger particle with the help of sieve, then this is called sieving. So if you want to separate the fine particles from the larger particles with the help of sieve, then this process is called sieving. And what is sieving? If you want to separate the fine particles from the larger particles with the help of sieve, then this is called sieving. And where can it used? This method is used in a flour mill where impurities like husk and stones are removed from wheat before grinding it. So if you want to separate the fine particles from the larger particles with the help of sieve, then this process is called sieving. And where can it be used? This method is used in the flour mill where impurities like husk and stones are removed from wheat before grinding it. So what is sieving? If you want to separate the mixture with the help of sieve, then this process is called sieving. And where can it be used? This method is used in the flour mill. This sieving method is used in the flour mill where flour is separated from the mixture. And in this method, we use the sieving. And in this method, husk and stones are removed from the wheat and with the help of sieve, we can separate husk and stones from the wheat in a flour mill. And this method is also used at our homes where fine flour particles are separated from the bigger impurities by using a sieve. So what do you mean by sieving? If you want to separate the fine particles from the larger particles with the help of sieve, then this is called sieving. And where it is used? It is used in the flour mill in which husk and stones are removed. So this is the method used in the flour mill. And this method is also used in our homes where fine flour particles are separated from the bigger impurities by using a sieve. So what do you mean by sieving? If you want to separate the fine particles from the larger particles by using a sieve, so this process is called sieving. And where can it be used? It can be used in a flour mill. It can be used in the flour mill in which husks and stones are removed from the wheat before grinding it. And this method is also used at our home where fine flour particles are separated from the bigger impurities with the help of sieve. So what do you mean by sieving? If you want to separate the larger particles from the smaller particles with the help of sieve, then this process is called sieving. And where can it be used? This is used to separate the bigger impurities with the help of sieve, and this is also used in the flour mill. This is used in the flour mill. Next is, how will you separate sand and water from their mixture? So we have discussed this in the previous class. How can we separate sand and water? Sand and water can be separated by the two methods. First is sedimentation and decantation, and next is filtration. So what is the process? How can we separate sand and water? So what is the process? First is sedimentation and decantation, and next is filtration. First is sedimentation and decantation, and second is filtration. So how can we separate sand and salt? It can be separated with the help of sedimentation and decantation, and it also can be separated with the help of filtration. So what do you mean by sedimentation and decantation, and how can we separate this with the help of this? And firstly, we will put sand and we will put the sand and water. We will put the sand and water, sand and water, and then we will put this mixture for undisturbed for some time. Then the sand is heavier, so it will not dissolve into the water. So it is settled down at the water, and then this is called sedimentation. When sand is settled down at the water bottom of the water, so this is called sedimentation. And if the water is poured into the another container, then this is called decantation. So this is called decantation. And next is filtration. What do you mean by filtration? When mixture of sand and water is passed through a filter paper, and sand particles being larger in size are retained by the filter paper, and it is separated from the water. So what do you mean by filtration? If we put the mixture of sand and water with the help of filter paper, then as we know, sand particles are larger in size. So it can be retained by the filter paper and it can be separated by the water. So what is the filtration process? If we put the mixture of sand and water through a filter paper, and this filter paper has very small fine pores in it. As we know, the sand particles being larger in size, they are retained by the filter paper and it is separated from the water. So what is the process? Firstly, we will put the sand into the water, and then sand settle down at the bottom of the water. So this is called sedimentation. And then water is poured into the another container. Then this is called decantation. And next is, what do you mean by filtration? If we put the sand and water through the filter paper, as we know, the sand particles are very large. So it can be retained by the filter paper. And then the water is separated from the sand with the help of filtration. So with the help of filtration, we can separate sand and water. So this is, what is the question 6? Is it possible to separate sugar mixed with wheat flour? If sugar is mixed with the wheat flour, if yes, then how will you do it? If sugar is mixed with the wheat flour, can we separate? Yes, sugar can be separated from the wheat flour with the help of sieving. With the help of sieve, wheat flour can be separated from the sugar. As we know, sugar particles are very larger in size, so it can be retained by the sieve and wheat flour pass through it. जो हमारे जो wheat flour होता है, जो आटा होता है, अगर उसके अंदर sugar mix है, तो उसको हम कैसे हम separate कर सकते हैं? छाननी की हेल्प से हम separate कर सकते हैं. जो sugar particles हैं, जो चीनी के particles हैं, वो छाननी में रह जाएंगे क्योंकि वो large size हैं. और उसके बाद जो हमारे जो उसमें पानी है, जो sugar particle है, वो larger size है, वो ऊपर रह जाएंगे. और जो नीचे क्या रह जाएंगे, हमारे जो wheat flour है, वो नीचे चला जाएगा. So next is, how would you obtain clear water from a sample of muddy water? So how can you obtain clear water from a sample of muddy water? So how can you obtain clean water from a with the help from the muddy water? As we know, muddy water contains very impurities, great impurities. So how can we separate? How can we obtain clear water? We can obtain clear water with the help of filtration. With the help of filtration, we can separate the muddy water. We can obtain the clear water. So what is the method? In this method, we use a filter paper, and this filter paper is fixed into the funnel. And then the mixture is poured into the filter paper. And as we know, the mud particles being larger in size, and they will remain on the filter paper and the clear water will pass through it. So how would you obtain clear water from a sample of muddy water? We can obtain the clear water from the muddy water with the help of filtration. And what is the filtration process? In this method, we use a filter paper, and this filter paper is fixed into the funnel. And if the mixture is poured into the water in the filter paper, then these mud particles, they are being larger in size, then they will remain on the filter paper and the clear water pass through it. So the clear water passed through it, and the mud particles being larger in size, they will remain on the filter paper. So this is the method. So how can we obtain clear water from a sample of muddy water? So how can we obtain clear water from a sample of muddy water? So in this method, we use a filter paper. We use a filter paper fixed into the funnel. So this mixture is, when this mixture is poured into the filter paper, then the mud particles being larger in size, they will remain on the filter paper, whereas the clear water will pass through it. Whereas the clear water will pass through it. So next is fill-ups. First is the method of separating seed-soaked paddy from the stalks. So what do you mean by threshing? If you want to separate the stalks from the mixture, so you need the process of threshing. So this is the threshing. So next is, when milk cooled after boiling is poured onto a piece of cloth, the cream malai is left behind on it. And the process of separating cream from milk is an example of filtration. When milk, when it is cooled after boiling, then when it is poured into a piece of cloth, then the malai is left behind on it. And the process of separating this cream from milk is an example of filtration. So this is the example of filtration. When it is cooled after boiling, then when it is poured into a piece of cloth, and then this malai is left. So this is the process of separating cream from milk, and it is an example of filtration. Next is salt is obtained from the sea water by the process of dash. If you want to separate the sand salt from the sea water, then this can be separated by the process of evaporation. So it can be separated by the process of evaporation. When sea water is kept in the sunlight, then the water evaporates and salt is obtained. So this process is called evaporation. Next is impurities settled at the bottom when muddy water was kept overnight in the bucket. So if we put the muddy water into any bucket and if it kept at the whole night, then the what is remaining, then at the bottom mud collects, and then the clear water was then poured off from the top. And what is the process? So this process is called sedimentation and decantation. So this process is called sedimentation and decantation. Next is true false. So first is a mixture of milk and water. If there's a mixture of milk and water, so how it can be separated with the help of filtration? Milk and water, can we separate the milk and water with the help of filtration? No. So filtration is used if the solid impurities are present. If solid impurities are present in the liquid, so we use the method of filtration. अगर हमारे filtration में कोई solid impurities liquid के अंदर है, तो हमारे जो हम process use करेंगे filtration, और उसके बाद अगर हम ये अवेलेबल नहीं है तो हम फिल्ट्रेशन यूज नहीं करेंगे. नेक्स्ट इज अ मिक्सचर ऑफ पाउडर सोल्ट एंड शुगर कैन बी सेपरेटेड बाय द प्रोसेस ऑफ विनोइंग. तो अगर पाउडर सोल्ट और शुगर को अगर हम सेपरेट करेंगे बाय द प्रोसेस ऑफ विनोइंग, सो अ मिक्सचर ऑफ पाउडर सोल्ट एंड शुगर कैन बी सेपरेटेड बाय द प्रोसेस ऑफ विनोइंग. इज दिस ट्रू और फॉल्स? There is a mixture of salt and sugar. There is a mixture of salt and sugar. Can we separate it with the help of winnowing? No. When winnowing is used, if the one is lighter particles and another is heavier particles, and it can be separated with the help of wind. But the size of the particles of sand and sugar is almost both are heavy particles. They both are heavy particles. So, and winnowing is used to separate lighter particles from the heavier particles. So, winnowing is used to separate heavier particles from the lighter particles. Next is separation of sugar from the tea can be done with the filtration. Separation of sugar from the tea can be done with the help of filtration. So this is true or false? If you want to separate the sugar from the tea, can we separate it with the help of filtration? No, because there is a mixture of sugar from the tea and sugar dissolve into the tea. So we cannot separate it with the help of filtration. Next is grain and husk can be separated by the process of decantation. It is also false. Decantation is used to separate solid impurities from the liquid. So it cannot be used to separate the grain and husk. And next is lemonade is prepared by mixing lemon juice and sugar into the water. As we know, lemonade, how can we prepare lemonade? It is prepared by the mixing lemon juice and the sugar into the water. And if you wish to add ice to cool it, should you add ice to the lemonade before or after dissolving sugar? And in which case would it be possible to dissolve more sugar? जो lemonade है हम कैसे prepare करते हैं?
बाय मिक्सिंग लेमन जूस को और शुगर को मिक्स करते हैं वाटर के अंदर, एंड उसके अंदर हम आइस भी डाल सकते हैं उसको ठंडा करने के लिए. शुड यू एड आइस टू द लेमोनेड बिफोर और आफ्टर डिजोल्विंग शुगर? जो हम आइस डालते हैं उसमें क्या हम शुगर डिजोल्व करने से पहले डालते हैं या बाद में डालते हैं? इन विच केस वुड इट बी पॉसिबल टू डिजोल्व मोर शुगर? किस केस में जो है मोर शुगर डिजोल्व होगी? वी शुड एड आइस टू द लेमोनेड आफ्टर डिजोल्विंग शुगर. इज इट पॉसिबल टू डिजोल्व मोर शुगर बिफोर एडिंग आइस? सो वी शुड इफ वी एड आइस टू द लेमोनेड आफ्टर डिजोल्विंग शुगर, is it possible to dissolve more sugar before adding ice? Because as the temperature is decreased, dissolving power of water also get decreased. So if we want to add the ice, we should add ice to the lemonade after dissolving sugar. If we dissolve the sugar, then we can add ice. Is it possible to dissolve more sugar before adding ice? Because as the temperature is decreased, dissolving power of water also get decreased. जो हम आइस डालेंगे हम लेमोनेड में शुगर डिजोल्व करने से पहले डालेंगे. अगर हम शुगर डिजोल्व करने पहले हम आइस डाल देंगे तो उसके बाद अगर हम शुगर डालते हैं तो वो शुगर डिजोल्व नहीं होगी. तो वी शुड एड आइस टू द लेमोनेड आफ्टर डिजोल्विंग शुगर. सो इज इट इज पॉसिबल टू डिजोल्व मोर शुगर बिफोर एडिंग आइस? Because as the temperature is decreased and dissolving power of water also get decreased. So you have to read this question and you have to write this question on the notebook and you have to also learn this question in the notebook. So again, I'm repeating why we need to separate different components of a mixture, to separate useful and from the non-useful components. And what are the examples? Tea leaves were separated from the tea and pebbles are separated from the rice. And next is, what is winnowing? The process of separating heavier and lighter components of a mixture with the help of wind. And how can you separate dust or husk or dust particles? So husk and dirt particles, it can be separated with the help of winnowing. And if you want to separate the heavier and lighter components of a mixture with the help of wind or with the help of blowing air, so it is used to separate the heavier and lighter components. So what is sieving? If you want to separate the fine particles from the larger particles with the help of sieve, then this is called sieving. And where can it be used? It can be used in the flour mill. When the husk and stones are removed from the wheat before grinding it. And next is, how can we separate sand and salt from the mixture, water from the mixture? So it can be separated with the help of sedimentation, decantation, and filtration can also be used to separate sand from the water. So is it possible to separate sugar mixed with the wheat flour? If yes, how you do it? So it can be separate with the help of sieving. With the help of sieve, we can separate the sugar and wheat flour. And next is, how would you obtain clear water from a sample of muddy water? It can be separated with the help of filtration. And next is fill-ups. The process of separating seeds of paddy from the stalks, then this is called threshing. When milk is cooled after boiling it, then the process of separating cream from the milk, then this is called filtration. And salt is obtained from the seawater, then this is also called evaporation. And next is true-false. And next is, lemonade is prepared by the mixing lemon juice and the sugar into the water. If you wish to add ice to cool it, should you add ice to the lemonade before or after dissolving sugar? In which case would it possible to dissolve more sugar it? So you, we should add ice to the lemonade after dissolving sugar. Is it possible to dissolve more sugar before adding ice as the temperature is decreased? So we should add ice to the lemonade after dissolving sugar. So if you have any query regarding this topic, you can ask. If you have any query regarding this question answer, you can ask.